Welcome to Geocasts. Today, I'm showing you how to add a simple Google map with a marker to a web page using the Google Maps Platform JavaScript API. In order to follow along, I recommend that you have a beginner or intermediate knowledge of HTML and CSS, and a little knowledge of JavaScript. I'm going to be using VS Code, but you can use whatever IDE you prefer. I'm going to walk you through a couple of steps to create a Google map with a marker on your web page. Creating an HTML page, and adding a map with a marker. If you're like me, and you'd prefer not to have to transcribe a bunch of HTML from a video, good news. You can find all of the code I'm going to show you in the documentation link below. All right, ready to get started? Let's dive into step one, creating an HTML page. First, start a new HTML file and open it in your IDE. Note that I'm going to be putting my HTML, CSS, and JavaScript into this HTML file for simplicity's sake. All right, I start by adding the code for a basic HTML web page. You'll notice that this is a very basic page. I'm keeping it simple for the sake of example. You can add any content you like to the web page to zhuzh it up. So if you open a Chrome window with the code we have so far, it works, but it seems to be missing a key feature, the map. Let's walk through how to load the Maps JavaScript API into your web page and how to write your own JavaScript that uses the API to add a map with a marker on it. We will be using two objects from the Maps JavaScript API, map and marker. Instantiating a map creates a new map inside of a given HTML container, which is typically a div element. The constructor passes a list of map options, which are optional properties, like a string representing background color and a Boolean representing draggable. For a complete list of properties, check out the reference link below. Instantiating a marker creates a marker with the option specified. If a map is specified, the marker is added to the map upon construction. In our case, we'll pass the map we created to the marker constructor so that the marker will be added to our map. As a side note, the position property of a marker must be set for the marker to display. Here we are, back at our code. Add the script that loads the API from the specified URL. The callback parameter executes a function called initmap after the API loads. You will write this function shortly. I include the async attribute to the script as it allows the browser to continue rendering the rest of the page while the API loads. The key parameter contains your API key. Find out how to generate your API key in the Geocast episode, How to Generate and Restrict API Keys for Google Maps Platform, which I've linked below. Now, even if you've already generated an API key, I highly recommend that you check out this Geocast because it includes important information on how to make your key more secure through restrictions. Below the div, add a new script tag. This is where we'll add the initmap function. I declare a variable for the location I want to pin on the map. I'm choosing Uluru in the Uluru Kata Tjuta National Park in Australia. This object contains the latitude and longitude of Uluru. If you're interested in marking a different location, a simple way to find the latitude and longitude is to open Google Maps and press on the desired location on the screen. This shows what is at that location as well as the latitude and longitude. Add the getElementById function to find the map div on the web page. New google.maps.map creates a new Google Maps object. The center property tells the API where to center the map. The zoom property specifies the zoom level for the map. A zoom of 0 is the lowest zoom and displays the entire Earth. Set the zoom value higher to zoom into the Earth at a higher resolution. To instantiate a new marker and put it on the map, use the google.maps.marker function, passing a position and a map. The position in this case will be Uluru. The map parameter is the map that we just created. Save your code and open the file in Chrome. You'll see a map of Australia with a marker on Uluru. If you are unable to see the map, walk back through the steps to make sure you didn't miss anything, or open Chrome's developer tools to check for errors. This can help you more quickly narrow down the issue. You just added your first map to the JavaScript API. Nice work. To learn more about using Google Maps in your apps, check out the rest of the Geocast series.